County taxpayers will be on the hook to pay for the discrimination settlement awarded a police officer.
News 4 has been looking closer at the $10.25 million settlement agreement over the lawsuit by Lieutenant Keith Wildhaber. Russell Kinsall is live detailing what it'll cost you and whether it'll leave less money for police or even simple fixes like potholes.
Yeah, well, right now, St. Louis County is moving forward with a plan to sell bonds to come up with that $10 million right away so they don't take it out of the budget all at once. That's quite a hit on the budget to do that. They will pay it out over a 30-year period like a loan with interest. So depending on the interest, that comes down to about $15 to $18 for every man, woman, and child living in St. Louis County because of the discrimination against Lieutenant Wildhaber. St. Louis County Council Chairwoman Lisa Clancy is glad the county could reach a settlement.
I'm pleased now that this dark cloud that's been hanging over St. Louis County for the past few months as a result of this case is now clearing up a little bit, and we've got some resolution.
The settlement is less than the $20 million the jury awarded Keith Wildhaber, who was passed over for promotion 23 times. Wildhaber won't get the full $10.25 million settlement. Here's how it'll be divided up. He'll walk away with $6,475,000. His attorneys will split the rest. County Executive Sam Pate said at a press conference Monday, no money from Prop P will be used.
This settlement will be paid through general revenue, through a mechanism that we can bond and limit the present day impact to our budget and maintain our normal operations of county government.
Pate's office says the county will use money in a reserve account to pay the annual payment of $500,000 to $600,000, and it won't take away money budgeted for pothole repairs or other county services. Here's how the county will pay Wildhaber the settlement money. The county's agreed to pay $7 million within 60 days, then the county will pay $3.25 million by January 31st of 2021. Page says Police Chief John Bellmer's decision to retire was not part of the settlement or because Page asked him to, but Clancy says it was time for a leadership change.
I think that this case and other challenges that have come to light within our police department over the past few months have let everyone know probably that change was inevitable.
St. Louis County hopes to recoup some of that money from its insurance company. Still some haggling to do over just how much. I reached out to the police department to ask, has anybody been fired or disciplined in any way because of the discrimination that's now costing the county $10 million? The answer was no. Live in Clayton, Russell Kinsall, News 4.